ลัทธิ Digestive Endoscopy Center create FC US series for endoscopy education. You can enjoy for your available time. We would like to express our gratitude to Professor Nontri Paul Sawat, President Thai Association for Gastrointestinal Endoscopy, who support and endorse this program. Also, I'd like to thank Boston Scientific Thailand for great support as well. We appreciate and thanks Dr. Thayaporn Chantharosiri, who draw this beautiful medical illustration in this program. The main objective of this program to emphasize practical points to perform US procedure successfully and safely.
FC US series number 5, US Billy Dennett. This includes indication, accessory device, technical aspect, and avoid adverse event. Indication. The main indication for USBD, the optic joint patient who require Billy Dennett after failed VRCP or insensible ambula or secondary arterectomy. Consider USBD at the first line in selected case. Some contraindication need to be concerned before starting USBD. 3. RCT study, one from US, two from Korea. USBD first line compared with RCP in malignant distal bladder obstruction. You can see technical success, clinical success, procedure times quite similar. Only multicenter in Korea study found high significance and low intervention in BD.
USBD consider first line option for selected palliative malignant distal bladder obstruction, especially pediatrical cannulation in large tumor and big bile duct with experienced hand.
Accessory and device.
Standard instrumentation, therapeutic linear echo endoscope, CO2 subphaser, fluoroscopy, electrosurgical unit, and various accessory need to be prepared. 19G standard FNA needle, O25 VC guide strip wire. In difficult case, might be need to remove O32. And in some particular case, decimal duct, maybe O18 lower go, need to be prepared with 22G needle. Catheter, double catheter, in some particular case. But this double Y catheter is not available worldwide. Professor Todd Ballon recommend use cytobus and remove bus to insert second Y. Tech dilatation prefer sequence cystotome over dilator. Anyway, after tip, hard dilator, easy dilator, one of the good option. 4mm hurricane balloon. Plastic stent and prepare proper metal stent. Skillful assistant is one of the important factor to get success. Prefer metal stent over plastic stent in malignant patients. For HGS, prefer partially cover, uncover part inside the liver, cover part in the gastric part. The ratio between uncover and cover prefer 70-30 or 80-20 over 50-50. Many design, for example, anti-migrating flap. And right now, the cover part is big frank to prevent inward migration. For CDS, mostly used fully cover. And lamps only for sedate in selected patients. In benign condition, use only fully covered stent or partial stent. Select lumen opposing stent only in sedate with specific criteria. Number one, ascites. Number two, high puncture site. And number three, subsequent interductal treatment. Luminal diameter 6 to 10 mm in diameter and 10 mm in length. A couple of lamps used in CDS, hot axial system and hot spexus system. Hot axial system, this hot axial device, the handle, hydrophilic sheet catheter, micro wire additive for burning, remove biopsy cap, insert hydrophilic catheter sheet in biopsy channel, lock the lock at the biopsy hub and rotate the handle until endoscopist can see the number. Attach electrocycle cable to monopolar hub. Setting for PL cut setting. This control for catheter. Backup for catheter movement in step 1 and step 3. Remove yellow septic clip for clay hub deployment system. This clay hub moving up for stent deployment in step 2 and step 4. This is the technique to deploy hot axial. This original technique to see the back mark burning, put the catheter inside the target area. Deploy the first fang in the lesion. And then fully deploy the first fang, pull back to see the endoscopic view, you can see the back mark, and then deploy the second fang. This old deploy technique under endoscopic guidance. There are four steps for hot axial deployment system. Insert the catheter into the working channel, lock at the biopsy hub, rotate the handle to see the number. Keep the tip of the catheter outside the scope. Check electro cable. Check electro circle setting. Unlock and paste catheter down to see indentation. Start burning and then put the catheter down. Approximately 3 cm. Keep one thumb wide. This step 1. Burning and put the catheter down approximately 3 cm. Step 2. Lock back. Relieve yellow septic clip by paste down. Unlock the gay hub. And then move gay hub up until the sound click. That first fang deployment. This first fang deployment. Step 3. Unlock, pull sheet catheter back until stent snack on the wall. Step 4. The last step for deploy second fang with interchannel deployment technique. Lock back, unlock clay hub, move clay hub up to number 4 until the sound click. Switch to endoscopic view, put some air, move scope back slowly and slightly clockwise to see the stent. Unlock, then put sheet catheter down strongly. Switch to endoscopic view. Slowly pull back and cock right until to see the stent. Unlock and then put sheet catheter. Spexus system same as Nagi stent system. Core system and hot system with ectocautery tip. RUMARK for endoscopic deployment, same as BACMARK hot Excel system. Outer X-ray marker and inner X-ray marker, these two marker for follow guidance deployment for the first fang. When remove the catheter sheath to deploy the first fang, the outer X-ray marker will list inner X-ray marker, the first fang fully open. For endoscopic deployment guidance, pull back the catheter by lock the sheath catheter first, then pull back until to see the blue mark. That means can deploy the second fang. Right now, recommend to use inter-channel deployment technique. This model to show you how to deploy under endoscopic view of Spexa system. This called Spexa put the Y in. Burn, dilate, and then put the stent, deploy the first fang, pull back, switch to endoscopic view to see the blue mark, and then deploy the second fang. This endoscopic guidance deploy Spexa system. Some new device is coming. The first one is stable access needle. You can see the needle tip can rotate for helping negotiate wide. Second one is extremely taper, stiff, and small delivery system. May be helpful for HGS. Technical aspect. I would like to thank all pioneers to create USBD. This is a group of family of USBD. Tan Mural, Dilex, Frenet, Critical Donostomy, Hepatical Gastrostomy, or assist Wiling in Long the Wool, or assist Indicate Stenting. Prior preparation before USBD, procedure plan depending on Nicole Fisher and Cosino Imaging, Malian distal structure, you can use Tan Reno with CDS. Or tan cathic in case of dilated interfaced bilac or scoliotomy. For hilar structure, only tan cathic approach with HGS or anticlate. Reserve long the wool for benign and accessible ampulla. Given prophylactic antibiotic, fasting at least 6 hours, good sedation or general anesthesia. If ESP perform the same time, considering minimize port ESP pancreatitis. There are 6 technical steps for USBD. Step 1, identify proper dilated PD with good position and direction. Step 2, puncture with 19 gauge needle. Step 3, make cholangiography. Step 4, why manipulation is the most important step. Step 5, tag dilatation. And step 6, stent insertion and deployment. Start with HGS. This bilac B2 and B3 anatomy and scope position. Adjust scope position by in and out to find the proper dilated B3. And then tip up direction to keep needle direction to the hilum. This good illustration provided by Professor Nakai and Professor Isayama. Picture illustration for step technique HGS. Step 1, identify dilated proper duct, already described, check Doppler. Step 2, needle puncture with 19G needle. Step 3, make cholangiogram prior optional aspiration, and then wash out with saline to clean contact from the channel. Step 4, insertion Y and Y manipulation deeply into intrapeptic for keep stable position of the Y. Step 5, tag direction with 6 venous atom. Step 6, insert metal stent if encounter difficulty, use 4 mm hurricane balloon dilate before, and then keep methoxsten deeply in diabetic and deploy, keep proximal end of the stent at the proper location, and then inter-channel deployment, keep 3 to 5 cm of distal end in the stomach side. This short video clip HGS needle puncture, contrast, wiring, and stabilization, then stent insertion. This inter-channel deployment, you can see stent inside the gastric part, and then put stent down. Technical step of US aggregate stenting same as SGS from step 1 to step 5, but require wide modulation from intrahepatic bioduct down to the duodenum. This is the most difficult part, and then dilate sixth part with quarterly or non-quarterly and balloon dilatation for adequate stent placement. Select proper stent and then deploy stent as the same ERCP fashion. Video demonstrate aggregate stenting. Put the wire in and dilate the sticker part with the balloon. This 8 mm hurricane balloon sticker dilatation. Quite tight sticker. To make sure adequate dilatation, and then place stent. Proximal stent at the duodenal side. Keep 1.5 to 2 cm in duodenal side. And then slowly deploy the distal end in the intrahepatic bioduct. At the puncture site, maybe put one plastic stent to minimize bile leak. This picture illustrates the scoriation in J shape and the needle direction up to the hilum of the liver. This US image of the dilated of the bioduct. Step technique for CDS. Step number 1, identify dilated buffer duct. Check Doppler. Step 2, needle puncture with 19 gauge needle. Step 3, aspiration and make cholangiogram clamp. Step 4, insert wire deeply into intrahepatic bioduct. And step 5, dilatation with 6 plain system or dilator. Step 6, insert make stent. If encounter difficulty, use 4 mm hurricane balloon for dilatation before, and then insert stent deeply into the bioduct and start deploy the stent. Keep the distal end of the stent in the duodenal pass 1.5 to 2 cm. This video illustration of CDS identify dilated bioduct. Insert the needle up to the hilum, aspiration, make cholangiogram. Wash saline in needle channel, and then insert wide deeply in the intrahepatic bioduct. And then take dilatation with 6 vein systole. Or dilator. You can see I'm manipulate Y in the left intrahepatic bioduct. And then insert 10 mm diameter 6 cm. Vortex fully covered stent. Keep distal end in the duodenum 1.5 cm. Consider lumen depot stent placement only in CDS with particular condition already mentioned. This hot axial single device four-step technique. The step one, identify the related proper CBD, indentation, burning, and put the stent inside. Step number two, deploy first fang. Step number three, pull back first fang, snap to the wall. And step four, deploy second fang in the channel, and then put second fang into the duodenum. Basically, hot axial need more than 2.5 cm space for deploy first fang safely. If the bidact less than 2 cm, recommend to put the needle in, inject the contrast, put the guide wire, and then insert stent over the guide wire and burning, and then deploy as step described previously. Some endoscopic inserts plastic stent inside hot axial system. Recommend 7 frame 5 cm double pigtail. Sedate with hot axial step 1 indentation, burn and putter inside the dilated bidact at least 2.5 to 3 cm. The step 2, open the first fang. You can see, fully open the first fang. And step 3, pull back the first fang attached to the wall. And then step 4, deploy the channel. And then switch to endoscopic view. Pull back a little bit, clockwise the scope. You can see the stent and put the catheter down to put the stent into the duodenum. For the CDS with hot cold spec sub, number one, put the needle in, inject the contrast cholangiogram, put the Y, take the dilation, balloon dilation, and then put stent in. You can see, pull back the outer excellent marker until least inner excellent marker. That means fully open the first fang. And then lock the catheter, pull back the catheter until to see the blue sheet in endoscopic view. This endoscopic view guidance, slowly pull back until to see the blue mark. When see the blue mark, and then unlock the catheter to open the second fang in the duodenum. This is the way to deploy closed plexus. This four study of USCDS with LAMP. Three use hot axial, one use plexus. You can see technical and clinical success 90%, even percent of adverse event. Interestingly, one of the major adverse event is a foot infection or some syndrome. This small RCC from Professor E.T. and Professor Andrew Thiel compared to tubular stent and axial stent. You can see same in terms of technical success, clinical success, adverse event. But adverse event tubular stents no some syndrome, but you can find some syndrome in lumen opposing stent. The last USBD is long the woo. Slong the woo is the US assist Y cannulation and then change to ESP scope for tanpapillary approach. You can use tanketic or tanduinal approach. For tanketic, prefer B2 than B3 because the B2 direction more straight compared with the B3. However, this approach needs dilated intermittent bidact. from D1 approach the tip of scope in the J-chip maneuver and tip down to the ampulla. This is good in terms of stable of the scope position, but difficult in terms of the Y manipulation. For D2, you can see the anatomy of D2, the direction of needle is straight to ampulla and short. That makes is the stability of this scope is not good as the D1, but easily to Y manipulation into the duodenum. This step technique is longitudinal truncated approach identified proper dilated by duct. Put the needle, 19 gauge needle, in the dilated by duct. Make cranchogram Y manipulation deeply into the duodenum. This is the most difficult part. And then remove the ear scope. Insert the ERCP scope. You can see the Y from the above. Two techniques. The first one alongside cannulation. The second one over the Y. Basically, prefer alongside cannulation first. And then put the catheter inside the biduct and readjust the guide Y. And then proper treatment of the stricture. The example of truncated rendezvous, put it in, make the contrast, Y manipulation down to the duodenum. Already mentioned this is the most difficult cast, might be need catheter for Y manipulation. And then change scope to ERCP scope and alongside cannulation. And then further treatment depend on the pathway of the patient. The final talk will describe technical aspects in detail, including how to avoid adverse event. Let's start with step one, identify proper dilated biduct with good position and direction. You can see in CDS, the good position of scope is J-shaped maneuver, and the scope tip up to the hilum of the liver. And for the HGS, prefer segment 3. The size of dilated biduct for the beginner recommend more than 8 mm and 3 to 5 if you get some experience. And rendezvous already mentioned about the tip and the scope position. Prefer D1 more than D2 because of scope stability. You can see this direction of the biduct into the hilum and keep the Y deeply into intrahepatic biduct. And this direction of HGS, you can see direction of the needle into the hilum. Number 2, puncture with 19 gauge needle, optional for 22 in small duct. And specific indication for LAM. For CDS, the needle direction up to the hilum already mentioned. For HGS, the needle direction to the hilum. For rendezvous, the needle direction down to the ampulla in D1. And also in D2, the direction down to the ampulla as well. This video to show segment 2 and segment 3 joined together. So this good direction to puncture in the B3 to the hilum of the liver. Sometimes when you puncture the needle, difficult into the biduct because stiffness of the wall of the biduct. In that particular case, you put the needle far further and then slowly pull back. you can see slowly put back into the bile duct and inject contrast to make cholangiocarp. For sedate with luminescent stent, you need to indentation and burn first. When you burn, and then you put the catheter inside and keep the catheter 2.5 cm and first fang deployment. Some complication might happen. Bleeding, you need to check the Doppler first and slightly rotate clockwise and counterclockwise to make sure no any small vessel nearby. The second one, double wall puncture. Normally, in CDS, the lunar wall really thin. So, if you find thickness, you need to put the water in to make sure no double wall puncture. Truncated puncture is recommended for the HGS and should avoid transitional puncture. This slide from Professor Hala to show you the severe complication in case of transitional puncture and mesonitis. He recommends to put the one clip at EG junction to make sure your scope tip and needle below EG junction. Sometimes when you puncture and then inject the contrast, you can see the contrast gone rapidly. That means you puncture in the vessel, not in the bile duct. And when you use LAM puncture directly, be careful portal vein injury with bleeding. Already mentioned, the size of the bile duct should more than 2 cm at least. If you use the single step device puncture with hot axial. If the duct smaller than 2 cm, recommend step with multi device. Put the needle first, inject the contrast, put the wire, and then follow with the cautery tip lamp. This technique more safe for the patient. The step three, cryptography, force it to make sure fit the good cryptogram and while manipulation up to the intrinsic part, not into the core matter. Same as HGS, you need to make good cryptogram to manipulate deeply into the proper side. One scan to show you the cryptogram and pentagram differently. It's number four, why manipulation, this is a more difficult part. When you inject the contrast, you wash the contrast out from the needle channel to make more safely for wire manipulation. Slowly wire manipulation to the target. For example, series manipulate wire into the intrahepatic, not into the gallbladder. For HGS, manipulate wire into the hilum or down to the extrahepatic bile duct. Be careful wire shearing. So very, very smooth manipulation. Not too rust. If difficult, might be changed to more floppy wire, for example, 032 to remove wire. The sample of the needle puncture contrast study, and then slowly put the wire in. You can see this is the tip of the vesicle. Very, very slowly manipulation. Recommend to use curved vesicle 025, more room to manipulate the guide wire. Very, very slowly. Take your time for wire manipulation. You can see wire into the hilum. And keep the step part deeply. Wire shearing is the main problem of wire manipulation, especially for the HGS. You need to be careful. If you encounter this problem for the HGS wire manipulation, Professor Okura recommends use liver impaction technique. You just pull back the needle from the duct into the liver parenchyma. You can see when you pull back more space for you to manipulate guide wire down to the hilum, not to the peripheral. This is a very good technique from Professor Okula. Once again, vibration for CDS into the intrahepatic, not in the gallbladder, and HGS into the liver hilum in stable position. Step 5, tactilization. Mostly recommend six Francis atom to burn with peel cut setting. You can use dilator with ultra taper tip. This easy dilator, it's very stiff dilator. For long the wound no require for tactilization. However, for lip balloon hurricane dilatation may be required if difficulty in terms of the stent insertion. Prefer cystotome over dinnite because of coaxial direction. You can see dinnite, the needle tip is not parallel with the guide wire. If only dinnite available, recommend to open the needle just only half to 3 mm to keep the needle tip parallel with the guide wire. And also you can see prefer easy dilator over surrender dilator because of ultra taper. The last step, step 6, stent insertion and deployment. You can see this inter-channel deployment, especially for the HGS. This technique to avoid inward migration, especially total migration into the perineal cavity, to make sure the distal end of the stent inside the gastric pass fully deploy in the channel and then put the stent out from the channel to the stomach. Normally keep the stent length in the stomach 3 to 5 cm. If the stent length shorter than 2 cm, recommend to put the clip to minimize inward migration. In early post procedure and you found some part of the stent inward migration, this encounter problem, recommend to put a clip or stent to cut the stent to avoid totally migration of the stent. In some particular situation, the second end of the stent in the esophagus or in the gastric part from CDS, recommend to move distal end to the gastric part in HGS and to the duodenal part in CDS to minimize in terms of the complication. Literature to show the mesenteric from the esophageal perforation when the distal end located inside the esophagus. And most of the complications by leak, the way to minimize by leak, the number one, keep the procedure as short possible, because more time you take, more risk you get, and use metal stent compare with the plastic stent and try to avoid large balloon dilation. Don't forget giving prophylactic antibiotic and always interventional radiologist and surgeon behind you. And post procedure care and follow up the patient. For early period, looking for complication might happen, infection, early stent migration, and the late period of the time, recurrent biliary obstruction in terms of the stent dysfunction, even migration or foot impaction. And in case of the benign, you need to schedule for intervention. In summary, USBD is good available option for very delicate if you fail VRCP or might be the first line selected patient. Type of procedure and stent should be proper select. Already mentioned 6-step procedure must be performed carefully and meticulously. Always keep interventionalist and surgeon backup you. And proper training and supervision is required for your great success. Hopefully you can get some small thing to improve your practice. Thank you, mate, for your kind visit to our channel. See you in next FC USC.